With the season-ending injury to Ravens running back J.K. Dobbins and the inexperience of one Tyson Williams and Nate McCrary, should the Ravens look to sign running back Todd Gurley out of free agency or even bring back a familiar face in Mark Ingram? These and many, many more questions on this episode of NFL Questions from subscribers. Yeah, this feels like a dream. And you know just what I mean. You see my boy, he like gotta made it, gotta made it. Boy, he's a fan and he like the Ravens, like the Ravens. YouTube team, keep it clean. What's going on? It's Engraven here with another video and another episode of NFL Questions from subscribers, a series where you can ask me any NFL question you want to, and we answer it in a video just like this. If you want to be part of it, you can send me an email to teamkeepitclean@gmail.com, or for the patrons, you can send it directly on Patreon. For anybody that wants to become a Patreon, you can go to patreon.com/engravenvids, and if you don't, you can stay right where you at. It's okay. I appreciate y'all either way. I love y'all. We got some fire questions as we always do. Without further ado, let's jump into it. So the first question on this episode came from my boy Louis E, Stefan M, and my boy Cam. So first, my guy Louis, he said, can the Ravens go ahead and sign Todd Gurley? So he was just straight up with it. It wasn't no beating around the bush, no cutting, no corner. No, he's like, no, can the Ravens just go ahead and sign Todd Gurley? Get it out the way, knock it out. My guy Stefan M, he said, who would you rather have to replace J.K., Todd Gurley or Le'Veon Bell? And he said he hoped the family is doing well, too. I appreciate that. And shout out to you, Ryman. Now, my guy Cam, he got a little more detail with it. He said, I was going to send this question in before I watched your latest J.K. Dobbins video, but here it goes. He said, you know, it's nothing but love for you and the fam over this way. Make sure you carve out time for all three. Oh, yeah, you already know, man. That's far more important than any of this stuff. And we spend a lot of time together. I know y'all see a lot of videos, and it's cool, but trust me, we in the fam, we always spending plenty of time together, man. But I appreciate you, man, because it's important. Priorities are important, man. But he said, I haven't submitted a question in a minute. That's true. You haven't. It's been a little while. But I was wondering if you wouldn't mind sharing your thoughts and new concerns with Team Keep It Clean and the Ravens flock concerning our current backfield situation now that J.K. will miss the season. Sucks for J.K. Dobbins. Injuries are the worst part about every sport. The fact that it can single-handedly ruin a season or career for budding superstars and players living out their dreams is devastating. However, I have no doubt that J.K. is going to come back stronger and more elusive than before. If you know just a little bit about his story, then you can see why I lack no faith in his triumphant return. I believe the mindset we see J.K. carry from the adversity he's overcome in life will lead him to a successful recovery and reemergence, as the mental part of recovery is often the most difficult aspect. That's true. I've been seeing Gurley this, Adrian Peterson that, veteran running back needed in Baltimore now. Both Gurley and AP have had tremendous success in their careers. No denying that. There are other veteran running backs who also have had success in the past. But I think their productivity would not exceed what we already have on our roster. Personally, I think we already have the running back stable to minimize this loss. I agree. Gus is no longer a bus. Ravens flock have been seeing me make this comment everywhere, but he's transformed into a Tesla truck. We know what he can do. And with his own emphasis on being a dual threat running back like J.K. in a passing game, I think Gus is poised for his best numerical season. I agree. Both rushing and receiving. The thing about J.K. and Gus is that we've been blessed to have two RB1s that can shoulder the load. Gus already proved that in Lamar's rookie season. True. And we know how much he's improved. Where things get interesting, in my opinion, is with Justice Hill. Tyson Williams and Nate McCrary. Tyson and Nate have been showing out in preseason. And I think if one of them can do a fraction of what Justice does on special teams, Justice is gone. Despite it being lower against the lower depth chart players in the preseason, we've still seen more out of Tyson and Nate than we have Justice. The way Tyson and Nate plays complements our offense nicely. And with those two splitting running back two carries for this season, I don't see why a rushing attack should drop off at all. I'm not saying this to say that J.K. is replaceable either. J.K. adds another dimension to our already dominant and historic rushing attack. I also see EDC using this situation to build up value in Tyson and Nate to explore other trade options when J.K. recovers and proves he's ready to go for next season. We know EDC be playing futuristic chess after all, LOL. Appreciate you taking the time to read this. Feels long-winded, but I'm sure you've gotten much longer than this. Yes, we have, for sure. But anyway, so for that question, that obviously a little more detailed than the first two, but still one and the same. So one, with my guy Lewis asking, should the Ravens go ahead and sign Todd Gurley? I would say no. But at the same time, I would not necessarily be opposed to it, but I could see them signing him or signing just another veteran running back. Reason being, because the Ravens, they typically don't really like to go young at those positions. They don't like when so much workload is put on a rookie. Because it's sort of like when you apply for a job. When you apply for a job and they say, hey, well, do you have any experience in this field? And you're like, no, I don't have any experience in this field. That's why I'm applying. Of course, you wouldn't say that in an interview. I hope not. But when they see you don't have any experience, they'd be like, oh, okay. Well, no, we're not going to be able to hire you. And you'll be thinking like, how can I get experience without getting experience? How can I do that? And it can be the same way in the NFL. How can you get experience to where you get to the level where coaching staff is comfortable with you without getting that experience? One of the most recent memories that come to my mind, I'm sure there are more, but one at the top of my head is with Orlando Brown Jr., his rookie year. His rookie year in the preseason, he was looking good. And I was like, and I know a lot of y'all were too, like, start Orlando Brown Jr. Let him be the right tackle. Let him do it, please. But they didn't. They went with James Hurst. James Hurst was the veteran at the time. He was obviously the more experienced guy. And they didn't want to go with the rookie. So then time passed. James Hurst struggled a little bit. And then he unfortunately ended up getting hurt. And it wasn't until that point where they put Orlando Brown Jr. in there and never looked back. He remained the starter ever since. And he did a good job as a starting right tackle for the Ravens. So it seems to be usually the Ravens are pretty much the same all across the board, where they don't want the rookies taking too much on their plate. Now, with the running back room, so with the Todd Gurley, that's why I say I could see the Ravens signing a Todd Gurley or signing another running back. Now, with the second question with Stephon, he asks, would I rather Todd Gurley or Le'Veon Bell? I think I would rather Todd Gurley. I do like Le'Veon Bell. Y'all already know that. Well, those of y'all who've been around for a couple of years, I like Le'Veon Bell a lot. But his style, to me, it does not fit what the Ravens do at all. His style of running is very, very patient. It's very, very patient. He is not one of those guys that gets the ball and takes off, hits the hole automatically. And that's what I feel you got to do with the Ravens. Whatever decision you make, whether you're running straight up, straight forward, straight through the hole, or you run into the outside, you bounce into the outside, whatever you do, you have to make quick decisions. And with Le'Veon Bell, with his style, he's very patient. He doesn't make quick decisions. So I don't feel like it would mesh with the Ravens' offense. And this is another shout out to Greg Roman, because that offense is very complex. It's very complex. The running offense is very, very complex. It's very, very detailed. That's why when people know the system, it's like, okay, yeah. When you get it, you get it. Now, with Lamar Jackson, like we've talked about, him being back there, it makes any running back that's next to him that much better and that much more of a threat, because teams got to watch for Lamar to take off too. Now, with my guy Cam, with what he was saying, I agree, because I said the same thing. I think the Ravens will be fine rolling on what they got. I really do. I think they will be just fine keeping who they have. Now, with Todd Gurley, somebody like him, I think they'll go into week one, and because Todd Gurley's out there. He's been out there. And then with all the roster cuts getting ready to happen over the next day, the running back free agency group is going to get even more crowded. So I think Ravens just sit back, like they usually do enough times with stuff. But I think they sit back. Look at Justin Houston. It worked out for him. I didn't want him to do it like that. I was like, hey, give up that comp pick. Y'all already know. But it worked out for him this time. But anyway, I think they're going to sit back and watch all the cuts. Just monitor who's out there. And you know Eric DaCosta, that's one thing about him. You know he is always looking to make this team get better. But I think they'll just sit back and wait to see who becomes available. And then, because they'll have a lot of options. They will have a lot of options, but it's about finding that right fit. Now, somebody else who has been topic of conversation when it comes to the running backs. And I've been like, initially, when somebody initially brought it up to me, my boy JT, I was like, no. But it was Mark Ingram. with Mark Ingram. And I've seen a lot of Ravens fans. And when I would see it in the comment section of the video about JK, I was like, oh, what? No, not Mark Ingram. What? So many of y'all was like ready to move on from him last year, especially because a lot of people were like, oh man, I told y'all, when fans say this, that means that they are done with a player. When they be like, oh man, I wish he could come back and be a coach, be a running backs coach. Whenever fans say that about a player, that means that they see that player as way past their prime and that they are not a serviceable player anymore. Fans used to say that so much about Eric Weddle. They used to always say that. Oh, man, I hope he can come back and coach the safeties or something like that. But anyway, with Mark Ingram, initially I was like, no. But I thought about last year. I'm like, no, he ain't really do much last year. But then I thought about what the biggest problem was last year with Mark Ingram. It wasn't that he was a bad runner. It was about, well, he did have two runners that were better than him, obviously with J.K. Dobbins and Gus Edwards, but it was that the Ravens were force-feeding everybody, really trying to share that workload to the max. And it was like, no, you don't have to do that, man. You don't have to do let J.K. and Gus do their thing. And it was at that point where they let J.K. and Gus do their thing, where J.K. and Gus really ate, especially J.K. But with Mark Ingram, if he was healthy, which he is, he's somebody that he knows the system. He knows the system. He's comfortable in the system. He obviously is comfortable in the locker room. We already know that. I know a lot of people have been thinking that he could possibly get cut with the Texans. So we'll see what happens with that, because there's been a lot of chatter about that for a while now. But now with roster cuts here, it could literally happen any second. So with Mark Ingram, if I had to choose between Todd Gurley, Le'Veon Bell, Mark Ingram, Adrian Peterson, and really any other running backs out there, if I had to choose, I honestly wouldn't be mad at Mark Ingram. I really wouldn't. Because, again, I thought about it a lot. Trust me, I did. But I really wouldn't be mad at because he knows the system. And with Mark Ingram, it's similar to Nate McCrary, and well, I guess Nate McCrary is similar to Mark Ingram for what they do. They make very, very good decisions, quick decisions too. And that's why I wouldn't mind rolling with what we got. Because they are obviously familiar with the system. They know the system. They've been learning the system all offseason. So, because with the Ravens running back room, I don't think it's necessarily a plug and play. I really don't, because of their style, the way they run the ball. It's not plug and play. You got guys that could do the job, man, but I think it's a lot more detailed than that, man. And not saying that these veteran guys, any like a Todd Gurley, like a Adrian Peterson, like a Frank Gore. Well, Frank Gore already knows the system, so that would help him if the Ravens were interested. He already knows the system a lot. He's very familiar with Greg Roman's system. But for any other veterans that haven't played in this system before, not saying that they couldn't learn it. But if you got guys that know, it would all depend on how much you want that running back that you just added to contribute. How early you want him to contribute. How much of a factor do you expect him to be in your running game? How often are you going to use him? But if they brought back Mark Ingram, I wouldn't be mad at that. But just to have him as sort of a reserve guy, maybe as a closer or something like that. Well, Gus is a great closer, though. Gus is a great starter. In the closer, but with him, again, since he knows the system, man, that's the biggest thing with me. He knows the system. Obviously, the team morale, everybody loves Mark Ingram. Like, everybody loves Mark Ingram. But it's more important than just loving the players. It's what they do on the field, too. So, yeah, I wouldn't be mad if they brought him back. I really wouldn't. And he would not be a starter, obviously. I wouldn't even want him to be RB2. Let him be RB3 or 4 or whatnot. Just so he stay ready so you ain't got to get ready. My guy JT, he was like, hey, you could just keep Mark Ingram's snaps down, keep his carries way down, and just have him ready for the playoffs, man. Have him ready for the playoffs. He got that experience. Again, knows the system. And I know I keep repeating that over and over and over and over again. But that's so important that he knows it. Because Tyson Williams, man, that dude, he's a home run hitter, man. And you put him behind a starting offensive line, too. That guy, and you put Lamar Jackson next. Oh, my goodness, man. Like, seriously, think about that, man. Look what he did. And yeah, I know it was against backups, but again, if he wasn't doing what he did against backups, then we would be having another conversation. But with Tyson Williams, you put him behind the starting offensive line, you put him next to Lamar Jackson, you get your starting blocking wide receivers out there too, the tight ends, all that stuff, and you put him with the Ravens offense, and just, man, that is going to be nice, man. I could almost guarantee it. He's going to be nice, man. Because with him, he's fast. He got some nice speed. And he'll cut. He'll make a move. And his speed won't drop off at all. It's the craziest thing to see. So, again, y'all know I would rather, when it comes to if the Ravens should sign Todd Gurley, I would rather them roll with who they have. I wouldn't be mad if they signed Todd Gurley, but I would much rather them roll with who they have. And when it comes to Todd Gurley or Le'Veon Bell, if I had to choose between the two, I would roll with Gurley. But again, when I look at all the free agent running backs or possible reunions for a running back, any possibilities for who the Ravens could bring in, obviously depending on what happens over there with Houston and Mark Ingram, that would probably be one of my top choices. And with Frank Gore, he's been playing like 15 years, but again, he knows the system. He knows the system. He's a bruising running back, but I probably wouldn't want them to sign Frank Gore, though. Probably wouldn't. But Mark Ingram, you know he can help in the passing game because that boy can catch. He can certainly catch. He did not have issues dropping that football in the passing game. So, yeah, if I had to choose out of everybody, I would say Mark Ingram. And if you would have asked me this 24 hours ago, that would not be my answer. But again, after a lot of conversation and after a lot of thinking about it, that would be my top choice. But my top choice over that is just rolling with the guys who are already there.